a loss of logic. And also we have discussed how to negate the expression, right? How to negate and simplify the expression using loss of logic. I have given some of the assignments. Most of them have tried. I'm happy. Okay, keep trying all the problems. Okay, kushi aitu work maadi tappadru parvagilla, right? Tapp maartane naavu kaliyak sadhya, right? Today we'll discuss a new concept. Two assignment problem what I have given yesterday, that I will record separately and I will send you soon. Okay, or else I will solve it and I will send through WhatsApp. Okay, very easy problem those two, but don't leave those two problems last class what I have given. Okay, if the time permits, I will record it separately and I will send it through WhatsApp. Okay, but don't leave that those two problems. Today we'll discuss a new problem, I mean new concept. We call it as rules of inference. Rules of inference. The next concept is a rules of inference. Okay, what do you mean by actually a rules of inference? A rules of inference is nothing but let us consider some propositions like p1, p2, p3, p4 up to pn. Let us take some propositions. Proposition nothing but a simple sentence. It may be a true or false, but not both. That is called as a propositions. Let us consider some propositions up to n. Okay, and the compound form of these proposition, the compound form of these proposition will give the conclusion as some result q. Right, after simplifying these propositions, we will get some conclusion q. This type of process is called as a rules of inference. So rules of inference is nothing but we are taking some set of propositions. Using that proposition, we will make some conclusion. That is called q. We call it as a rules of inference. Another way of argument is we will collect all the propositions. We will collect all the propositions using some rules. We will collect all the propositions using some rules. We will solve these propositions and finally we will get some solution q. Q is called as a solution. So this process is called as rules of inference. Innu tumba simple aagi local aagi helbeku andre ella propositions nu gudde haki, right, some rules matte logic na apply maadi conclusion na tarisbeku. A process in naave nanta kareethivi rules of inference anta helthivi. So the definition of rules of inference is let us consider some propositions using some rules, regulations, laws, properties, we will derive some solution. The solution is called as q. The whole process what we known as rules of inference, right? And this set of proposition is also called as premises. They are also called as premises. P1, P2, P3 are also called as a premises, right? Enanta karithira P1, P2, P3, P4 galu enanta karibodu premises anta helbodu, right? Premises galanna use maadkondo loss of logic galanna use maadkondo property galanna use maadkondo last anna result en tarbeku q anta tarbeku. Q andre adu yado one expression irbodu, right? So this is called as the rules of inference. So put a some point what you understood. Let us consider, take the point, let us consider some propositions like, let us consider some propositions like p1, p2, p3, p4 up to pn. Let us take some propositions p1, p2, p3, p4 up to pn along with the solution q. Along with the solution q, along with the solution Q. The solution is obtained by using some rules. The solution is obtained by using some rules. Laws of logic. Properties. The whole concept is known as rules of inference. Okay. Now, next paragraph you take. P1, P2, P3 are called as premises. P1, P2, P3, P4, these are called as premises. Q is called as solution. Solution or conclusion. Okay. Now, let us take some rules of inference. Okay. There are 10 to 12 rules of inference are there. I will write one after the other. Your main job is to remember all the rules of inference. Right. So if you won't remember, we can't do the problems. So we must put those laws in your head. Then only we can do the problems. So what I have to tell is today itself, I mean, today only you go through all the rules, remember all the rules, right? Sir, ಎಷ್ಟು rules ಇದೆ, ಎಷ್ಟು laws of logic ಇದೆ, ಎಷ್ಟು laws of set theory, ಹೆಂಗ್ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಸರ್? ಬೇರೆ ಶಾರ್ಟ್ ಕಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಓದ್ಲೇಬೇಕು ಅಷ್ಟೇ, ಬೇರೆ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಕಲೀಲೇಬೇಕು, ರೈಟ್? ನಾವ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಫಾರ್ ರೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಇನ್ಫರೆನ್ಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ದೀಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಟುಡೇ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಟೆಲ್ ಯು, ದೀಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಬಿಟ್ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಟ್ರ್ಯಾಕ್ ಈಚ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಸ್ಟೆಪ್ ಕೇರ್ಫುಲಿ. And most, first and foremost thing is, please join the class. If you are not attending today, you can't understand next upcoming 5 to 6 classes. That assurance I will give you. ಏನು ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಕೂರ್ಬೇಕು, ರೈಟ್? ಟಿವಿ ತರ ನೋಡ್ಬೇಕು, ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು ಅಷ್ಟೇ. ಏನು ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಇವತ್ತಿನ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಮಿಸ್ ಆದ್ರೆ, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಅಷ್ಟು ಹೇಳಿದ್ರು ಕೂಡ ಮಿಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. Can't tell anything now. Okay, no problem. We'll start the rules of inference now. Okay, let us take some rules. First rules of inference, first one. First rules of inference. You can go through WhatsApp what I have sent now itself. Okay, a few minutes back I have sent the laws, right? Go through it. First law: today may or may not be, I will do some problems. Today I will list out only the laws. First one, that is called as the rule of detachment. Rule of detachment. It is also called as modus ponens. It is also called as modus ponens. The rule of detachment. Modus ponens. The rule is, first one, P implies Q is Q itself. The first rule is P implies Q is Q itself. How we have written this one? First two, these two are called as premises. These two are called as premises. ಏನಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ? premises ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಫೈನಲ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಏನು ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಈ ತರ ಎರಡು ಪ್ರಿಮಿಸಿಸ್ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಆ ಜಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಬರೀಬಹುದು ಕ್ಯೂ ಅಂತ ಬರೀಬಹುದು ರೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಅಪ್ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ whenever we get these two statements on that place we can write q right next problem martha nimge gotagutte ee tara erdu statement bantu andre aa erdu jagadalli en baribodu q anta baribodu idan heegu baribodu nodi r idan ee tarano baribodu p first one is p and second statement is p implies q R anta barkoli R P and with P implies Q. What is the answer? For this answer is 2. Heng nenpidko bodu sir idana andre simple right? So iveradu cancel agutte anta bhavisi. Imagine these two get cancelled. What is the remaining? This is the way we can remember. ಒಂದು ಲಾ ಬರೀತ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೋಬಹುದು ಯಾವಾಗ ಹತ್ತು ಲಾ ಬರಿತೀನಿ ಹತ್ತನೇದು ಬರೆಯೋಷ್ಟೊತ್ತಿಗೆ ಒಂದೇ ಮರ್ತೋಗಿರುತ್ತೆ ರೈಟ್ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುವಂತ ಯಾವ್ದಾದ್ರು ಒಂದು ಕೀ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲಿದೆ ನೋಡಿ ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲಾ ಇಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಪಿ ಪಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ರಿಸಲ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ದೀಸ್ ಟು ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಮಿಸಿಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಿ ಅಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ P implies Q is Q. Second law. Second rules of inference. P implies Q. Q implies R. Therefore, P implies P implies Q, Q implies R. That indicates P implies R. Conclusion is P implies R. Conclusion hang baribek nodi three dots. Itara baribek. Adu conclusion anta. Now these two are called as premises, and this is called as conclusion. These two are called as premises and this is called as conclusion. So whenever we have these two statements in the problem, so on that case we can write P implies R. It is just like transitive law, correct? Observe, P implies Q, Q implies R, P implies R. Transitive property tara ida alva? A implies B, B implies C, that implies A implies C, correct? ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಹೇಗೆ ನೋಡಿ ಪಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಮತ್ತೆ ಕ್ಯೂ ಇಂದನೇ ಶುರುವಾಯಿತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸಿಟಿವ್ ಲಾ ಕ್ಯೂ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಟ್ ಇಂಡಿಕೇಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಪಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಆರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಆಸ್ ಇದು ಹೀಗೂ ಬರೀಬಹುದು ಆರ್ ಪಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಆರ್ Conclusion is what? P implies R. P implies Q and Q implies R. Result is what? P implies R. Right? This law is called as rules of syllogism. Write down heading. What is this law indicates? Rules of syllogism. Rules of syllogism syllogi rules of syllogism anta karithivi modalnedu yavudu modus ponens this is called as rules of syllogism next law third law the third one rules of inference It is called as modus tolerance. Modest tolerance. The law is called as modest tolerance. T-O-L-L-E-N-S. Right? So the law tells that the modest tolerance, P implies Q, negation Q, P implies Q, negation Q, conclusion is negation P. It is premises, this is called as conclusion. Right? How to remember this? P implies Q. If negation for this, then the negation for this also. Correct? P implies Q idella alli negation Q adre inne nodiyutta negation nodi iduk negation hakidre andre ernedu iduk negation hakidre en baruthe result first one negation it is called as modest tolerance. This rule is called as modest tolerance. Right? Nenpidkoli, P implies Q, negation Q hakidre, negation P barbeku answer. This law is called as modest tolerance. This also can be written as R, P implies Q and negation Q is negation P. P implies Q and negation Q. What you will get? Negation P. Next law. Rule of conjunction. Rule of conjunction. P, Q, two premises. P and with. How to remember this? P and Q. Asta. It is easy then put kodadalva. Bari easy though. ಎಷ್ಟು ಈಸಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈಗ ತಾನೇ ಹುಟ್ಟಿದ ಮಗುವಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಹಲ್ಲಿರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ದಂಗೆ ರೈಟ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಈಸಿಯಾಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬೋದು ಏನು ಇರಲ್ಲ ಸೊ ಇದು ಹಂಗೆ ಪಿ ಕ್ಯೂ ಪಿ ಆಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಆಸ್ ಆರ್ ಪಿ ಆಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಪಿ ಕ್ಯೂ ಇಸ್ ಪಿ ಆಂಡ್ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ರೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಕಂಜಂಕ್ಷನ್ ಹೆಸರುಗಳು ನೋಡಿ ರೈಟ್ 7 8 ಲಾಸ್ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಂಗೆ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಆ ಹೆಸರುಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಒಂಥರ ಮಿಕ್ಸಿಲ್ ಹಾಕಿ ಗ್ರೈಂಡ್ ಮಾಡ್ದಂಗೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಯಾವ್ದು ಯಾವ್ದು ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಿರಲ್ಲ ರೈಟ್ ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಯಾವಾಗ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ 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 ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ರೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಸ್ಜಂಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸಿಲ್ಲೋಗಿಸಂ ರೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ disjunctive syllogism rule of disjunctive syllogism rule of disjunctive disjunctive syllogism ಒಂತರ ಈ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ನೇಮ್ ಕೇಳ್ದಂಗ ಆಗ್ತಿಲ್ವಾ ಯಾವ್ದೋ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ನೇಮ್ ಕೇಳ್ದಂಗ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆಲ್ಲ ಇದು ಯಾವ ಡಿಸೀಸು ಅಲ್ಲ ರೈಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮಗೆ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಶುರುವಾಗುತ್ತೆ ನೋಡಿ ಶುರುವಾಗ್ಬೋದು ಬಟ್ ಇದ್ಯಾವುದು ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ರೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಡಿಸ್ಜಂಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸಿಲ್ಲೋಗಿಸಂ ರೈಟ್ the law P R with Q negation P is Q. P R with Q negation P is Q. These two are called as premises. This is called as conclusion. Conclusion is indicated by three dots. Okay, so in the next upcoming problem, whenever we have a statement, these two statements, on that case we can write Q. It's called rule of disjunctive syllogism. This also can be written as R P R with Q and negation P. P R with Q and negation P. Conclusion is what? Q. Conclusion is called Q. How to remember this? Negation P andre idakke negation hakidre result en barbeko Q barutte anta. Erdu statement correct a gamanisi. Negation P idak negation P bandre final answer enagirutte Q agirutte. Aathara nenpidkodi. Ondu negation bandre idak negation bandre result eno Q. It's called rule of disjunctive syllogism. Next law. Rule of conjunctive simplification. Rule of conjunctive simplification. Rule of conjunctive simplification. Simple law it is. See here, P and with Q. Only one premises. P and with Q. Only one premises. And result will be P. See, only one premises. One premises. One conclusion. P and with Q anta problem illadaru munde bandre aa case ni yen barivi P anta barivu right. Next problems martta nimige gothagutte sir elli use agutte idu anta problem alli ella on kade yado statement P and with Q irutte aa jagada yen baribodu P anta barivu right. Conclusion is what? This is called premises. This is called conclusion. So what is the law? Rule of conjunctive. Conjunction anta kelidira kelidare conjunction anta and operator ide alva and operator na conjunction anta karithivi. So adu nenpidkolod easy. Rule of conjunction anta bantu andre and operator be conjunction means and operator. Next law. Rule of disjunctive. Rule of disjunctive. Rule of disjunctive amplification. Rule of disjunctive amplification. Disjunctive nothing but R operator. Okay, so we can write like this. P, this can be written as P R with Q. One day premises. Yavadu P. Conclusion eno P R with Q. Andre problem alli ellaru yavadaru statement P anta idre neevu aa jagadalli en baribodu P R with Q anta baribodu anta. Right? Why it is called amplification? P We are not simplified here. We have amplified. See, we have a P, but what we have added, R with Q is added. That's what it is called amplification. Simplified alla. Bari P idre, P jothe R with Q add madidira. Hagage ad amplification anta karithivi. Disjunctive means which operator? R operator. Next law. The rules for proof by case. Rules for proof by cases. Rules for proof by cases. The law is P implies R, Q implies R. This is P R with Q implies R. Simple. ಇದೊಂಥರ ನೋಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ರೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಲ್ಲೋಗಿಸಮ್ ತರನೇ ಇದೆ, ಆದ್ರೆ ಅಲ್ಲ. ಸಿ ಪಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಆರ್, ಆರ್ ಇಂದನೇ ಶುರುವಾದ್ರೆ ಅದು ರೂಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಲ್ಲೋಗಿಸಮ್. ಪಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಆರ್, ಆರ್ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಎಸ್, ಆತರ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದು ರೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಿಲ್ಲೋಗಿಸಮ್. ಇದ್ಯಾವ್ದಿದು? ರೂಲ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಪ್ರೂಫ್ ಬೈ ಕೇಸಸ್ ಅಂತ. ಸೊ ಪಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಆರ್, ಕ್ಯೂ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಆರ್ ಅಂತ ಇದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನ ಏನಂತ ಬರೀಬಹುದು? ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್, ಪಿ ಆರ್ ವಿತ್ ಕ್ಯೂ implies R. Combine these two. Implies R. This is called rules for proof by cases. Next law. Next law, rules of constructive dilemma. Rules for constructive dilemma. Rules for constructive dilemma. Next, rules of inference. Right, the law is P implies Q, R implies S, P R with R, Q R with S. There are three premises we have. P implies R implies S, R R with R, P R with R, then the result is Q R with S. ಹೆಂಗ್ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೋಬಹುದು ನೋಡಿ, ಇವೆರಡು ಕಂಬೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ಕನ್ಕ್ಲೂಷನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಕ್ಯೂ ಆರ್ ವಿತ್ ಎಸ್ ಇವೆರಡು ಕಂಬೈನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಪ್ರಿಮಿಸಿಸ್ ಹೇಗಿರ್ಬೇಕು? ಪಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲಾಯ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ, ಕ್ಯೂ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಯಾವುದು? ಆರ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ. R implies S. ಈ ತರ ಇದ್ರೆ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ಯಾವ್ದೋ ಒಂದು ಕೀ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದನ್ನ ಹಿಡಿಬೇಕು ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಕ್ಕೆ. ಪಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ, ಕ್ಯೂ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಆರ್. ಆರ್ ಆರ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವೇರಿಯಬಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಸ್. ಪಿ ಕ್ಯೂ ಆರ್ ಎಸ್. ಪಿ ಆರ್ ವಿತ್ ಆರ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಇವು ಮೂರು ಜಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಂತ ಬರೀಬಹುದು? ಕ್ಯೂ ಆರ್ ವಿತ್ ಎಸ್. ಹೆಂಗ್ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೋಬಹುದು? ಇವೆರಡು ಕಂಬೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕ್ಯೂ ಆರ್ ವಿತ್. So which law it is? Rule of constructive dilemma. Next. next law, a rule of contradiction. Rule of contradiction. Rule of contradiction. Rule of contradiction. Negation P implies false. P itself. Negation P implies false is P itself. Rule of contradiction. Ila tumba kadame use madar now. Tumba ne kadame, but adru bardidini. Negation P implies F false can be written as P. Remove this negation, you will get P. This is a way to remember. Rule of contradiction. Okay. Now, these are the laws are very important. This is called rule of contradiction. Now, along with these rules, we should have some properties. ತಲೆನೋವು ನೋಡಿ ಇಷ್ಟು ರೂಲ್ಸ್ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಇನ್ನೂ ಒಂದಷ್ಟು ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಲೇಬೇಕು ನಾವು. ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಸಾಧ್ಯನೇ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಹಾಗಾದ್ರೆ ಯಾವೆಲ್ಲ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೋಬೇಕು? ಇದುವರೆಗೆ ನಾವು ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಮಾಡಿದೀವಿ ಆ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ. ಯಾವ್ದೇಳಿ? ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್, ಪಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಟಿ, ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಆಸ್ ನಗೇಷನ್ ಪಿ ಆರ್ ವಿತ್ ಕ್ಯೂ. ಇದ್ ನೆನ್ಪಿದೆ ಅಲ್ವಾ ನಿಮಗೆ? ಪಿ ಇಂಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ಕ್ಯೂ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ರಿಟನ್ ಆಸ್ negation p or with q. ಇದನ್ನೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬೇರೆ ತರ ಬರೀತೀನಿ ನೋಡಿ. ರೈಟ್, negation p p or with q, p or with q can be written as negation p implies q. ಹೀಗು ಬರೀಬಹುದು. ರೈಟ್, ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್. So, right, I will send you the link again. I will engage only 15 minutes. That's it. So, please join again. So, remember these two property. P R with Q can be written as negation P implies Q. Sir, how do you put it? Sir, I'm going to write it. First of all, P implies Q. Negation P R with Q. This negation, how do you write it? Negation?